He can't get it to the net. So much time to go in this hockey game. And then the Canadians now with a man advantage. And look out, the chance here for Radulov, and he scores. Fleury was interfered with a bit in front by Gallagher. And Radulov able to score, and Fleury did not have his goal stick when that puck went in.
Yeah, and I was watching that. Watch the player Gallagher go into the net. Not the shooter, Gallagher. He's pushed it a little bit into Marc-Andre Fleury. Then he tries to get out of the way. He loses his stick. Now, on his backside, Gallagher, as he comes to the blocker, is Dumoulin. Does Dumoulin shove him into Marc-Andre Fleury? Does he, Gallagher's pace interfere with Fleury's ability to make a play on that puck?
Couturier with the puck. Bounces back. Dawson's bear shot. What a save by Price. Couturier could not finish it. What a stop. Myers keep it in. Provorov to Reed, but he could not get it past Gemelin, who will lob it ahead. Radulov hanging out at the blue line. Has the empty net. And he scores. Radulov
in regulation as the Canucks let it all hang out. Loose puck, and it's a race. Radulov's going to get there, and he overskated the puck. And a penalty call has been made. Now they're going to call it a goal. They're going to call it a goal. And it is 3-0.
Well, anytime there's a penalty on an empty
net. Take a swat at this, and then there's the slash on the arm. And any penalty on a breakaway with an empty net, it results in a goal. So Radulov will get that one, and it'll be 3-0 Montreal. And the goalie out of the net, you know, 2 minutes to go, you got to take it, take him and take a crack at it.
Markov across for Galchenyuk, flipped it up ahead, and it's Radulov that brings it in, drags it around, Hoffman goes to the goal, scores! I don't know if there's a player on this team that enjoys playing in Montreal more than Alex Radulov. Little shake and bake right there. Mike Hoffman doesn't know what happened as Radulov puts it through his legs. And here's the thing with Radulov. He is a very strong skater, and he gets on those edges, goes hard to the net, drives to the blue paint. And
Gallagher on the puck. Long pass ahead for Pacioretty. Pacioretty in over the line with it. Drops it back. Alexander Radulov dancing in. Scores!
Stop it, Radulov. Was going to pass this puck as he comes to middle. Look at the great hands on Radulov. One thing Radulov has is a terrific backhand. He loves to use that backhand, uses a fairly straight stick, and because of that, he's able to get a lot on that backhand. There's Lewis. He loved that reaction if you're the Canadians.
Lacan has tried to rush it, and the rushing of the pass to Byron, it just got a bit behind him and hit his back skater. That might have been a tap-in on the back door. I'm kind of surprised that he didn't bring Pritchard back in. I really thought...
In front of the net, Radulov buries that, and it's 7.
It's a dump in, and it's just a sloppy play that continues for Colorado. They go in slow to get the puck, and you're 3 times the size of the player that's forechecking you, and you go in slow, and then there's Rene Bork, who just doesn't even pay attention.
Down to leaves the body as Mitchell will hand it off for Alexander Radulov. Up ahead for Paul Byron. Byron plays it into the Lightning zone. Vasilevsky's out of the net and got into trouble. Byron in front, they score! Alexander Radulov!
Wow, he steps up at just the right time. Paul Byron with a great forecheck, and Vasilevsky mishandles that puck. Bouncing puck, just can't corral. Tries to throw it by Byron. Byron picks up, and a nice, easy tap-in for Radulov, who stops right in front.
Knocked down in front of the net, the Canadian cleared out to Radulov. Got to center. Backhanded the pass ahead. It comes back to him. Scores! What a beautiful pass.
Comes out on a nice clean breakout. Montreal gets some rhythm coming through the neutral zone. For the Pittsburgh Penguins, the defensemen leave a slight gap. They get one on top of the other in the I formation out along the blue line. And you'll watch right here as they crisscross over each other. And that allows Weber to cut right through the middle. He drops it.
And now it's Bollier that's got it. Trying to set it up for Radulov, and he's got it. Alexander Radulov breaking in, scores! Alexander Radulov with a highlight reel.
Weber. Beaulieu back at the blue line. Weber, no chance to get that shot away there. They came right after him. Hyman skated right towards him. Nathan Beaulieu into the middle. This high wrist shot. In comes Weber. Backhander. He couldn't get it to the net. That was stopped. Radulov scores on the second chance.
That was won by the Maple Leafs. Komarov. But look at the quick jump there by Radulov. Lifts the stick of Polak. Great puck movement side to side. McCarron, that big body, 6'5" in front of Anderson. Anderson has no idea where the puck is there, but how about the play of Shea Weber?
Back to the line. Weber across for Beaulieu. Over to Radulov. Scores!
And Radulov starts it all off, gets the zone, over to Pacioretty, back to Radulov. And Beaulieu sells that like he's going to shoot the puck. Instead, nice little pass over to Radulov. Radulov all kinds of time, and the big thing...
Swings it across to Petrie. Backlund got his stick in the way of the pass. Andrew Shaw tried to move it. Tangled up with Weidman. And out of the net, Radulov scores!
Alexander Radulov. And Montreal wins the battle along the boards. And this puck is going to squirt loose to Radulov. Look at the quickness of the hands. Quickly to the backhand. And I think he surprises Chad Johnson on how quickly he elevates that puck.
Instead, here's Schmidt. Laid it off the leg of Pacioretty. Right back for Radulov. He scores!
This time, Pacioretty gets the turnover. Quick little pass from Philip Deneau. And a quick shot and a great celebration from Radulov. Nice little wrist shot in the high slot. Not sure if that got tipped or not. But a quick release, similar to that Beagle goal earlier. Radulov, quick snapshot a couple feet off the ice.
Missed. Petrie hustles quickly to get to it. Down low, Radulov in front, chance, scores! Alexander.
Montreal really starting to pick things up, and Radulov gets this puck. Look how quick those hands are in front of the net. Just the skill level. The puck pokes to Radulov to the backhand, the forehand. The lightning quick reel.
Montoya.
It's a 2-0 hockey game.
John Moore with his first goal since December 17th, and the Canadiens respond right back the other.
They win the faceoff, regroup that puck nicely, and look at the hand-eye coordination from Radulov. Just bats that puck down on his backhand, quickly puts it over to his forehand, and what a terrific release. Gets up on that front foot. And when you get on that front foot, you can see the entire net and a picture-perfect shot off the stick of Radulov.
So the Canadiens respond 11 seconds. Puck comes around the wing. Shore to the line. Hamhuis came in for it, but Pacioretty got it out. And it's Radulov breaking in the wall. Radulov scores!
Look at the hand-eye coordination. Right to the backhand, just where Radulov likes it. He's so good on the backhand, as good as most are on their forehands. It starts from his own zone. Out of a cannon, he just jumps, chips it to the forehand to the backhand, then goes up and over.
The cage, and back come the Canadians in. Puck fired point blank by Pacioretty, and he was stopped. Pacioretty with it again. Still after Radulov. Scores! It's over!
Plays it up ahead for Jonathan Huberdeau. Huberdeau off for Marchessault, back in front, knocked down by Deneau, and it's brought out, and Radulov from center for the empty net, they score! Alexander.
Centered across in front of the net, it'll come back out, Markov, back to Weber, he'll move it up, Pacioretty, shooting, score, it's over!
Challenging some of the top players of the Montreal Canadiens. Where have they been so far? And I'll tell you what, they helped to tie this game up, and they just helped to win it. Here's the one to the net, the battle in front. Montreal made a point of practicing it all day yesterday, getting bodies in front of the net, being on top of Henrik Lundqvist. They had bodies around them. We showed a bunch of the scrambles, and at the end of the day, it's a one battle over Zibanejad by Radulov. He wins the battle, and he wins the hockey game, and he gets his series back to even. What a big comeback for the Montreal Canadiens, who did it all year long.
The first sudden death overtime winner for Radulov in his career. And it's a big one. And you
call to Gary. He wins that battle with his second effort against Zibanejad. Gave it away to Radulov, who steps in, played it ahead. Dano, Radulov rumbling in there. Oh, what a goal!
Defense of their forwards. This is a problem they were having a good portion of the back end of the season, and here Klein puts it right on Radulov's stick, and then he walks right in and does the Peter Forsberg. I mean, this is not an easy thing to do with a guy draped all over you, and it just shows the strength and the agility and the talent of Alexander Radulov, who not only got the Canadiens back in this series with a great pass to Plekanec to tie it.